Now, I may should have filmed me making this. This is a catfish fillet. It's been breaded. And get off of there. So we got a catfish fillet. It's been fried in clarified butter or glee. Now, got that on there. Got some gumbo right there. Let's assemble a dish. Hey boys, hey girl. Today we're gonna make something I ain't never made before on video. We're gonna make a catfish meuniere. Okay? And I had this and reverse engineered it. Made it last night, but didn't do a video. I took a couple stills, because I just took a catfish fillet and did it meuniere style. And I had some leftover gumbo. And I took photos of that and a little short video. So what we got here is some Guidry's catfish fillets. These are frozen and they're from Henderson, Louisiana. Product of the USA. So we're gonna thaw these. Let me turn on the studio lights. Studio lights engaged. So, I know I can eat two. Miss JB says she want two. And so we're gonna take these fillets, and they frozen. I ain't feel like going out and catch no catfishes. So we're gonna put four of them in there. There's two mamas. Where the little other baby at? Got another baby catfish in there? Yeah, oh, looky, y'all. He folded up. He was sleeping when they caught him and cut him up. Oh. Ain't that a bitch. All right. So we're going to take a little bit of... We're going to defrost these in a brine. We're going to take some Cajun seasoning and chunk it in there. Take some salt. Hold them up. Don't be non-union. Some salt. Chunk it in there. And we'll add some water. And get them defrosted. Could you see down there? I hope so. So let me put some water on these. The instant dyed water. And let them start defrosting. Now for this recipe, we're going to need some clarified butter. Excuse me. Also known as ghee. You can find this at a lot of stores. G-H-E-E. It's clarified butter. And it's pretty easy to clarify butter. You get a stick of butter, or as much as you need. Put it in a saucepan on low heat. And let it melt. And it's gonna start bubbling and doing what it's supposed to do, and then shut the fire off. Shut it off for 5 minutes. Just that many. Or is it that many? 5 minutes, yeah. And then skim the foam off the top. And carefully pour the yellow clear liquid off the saucepan, leaving the heavy milk solids underneath. You can store this in the refrigerator in a tightly sealed container for about a month. Okay? And it's got a higher smoking point than regular butter because you done got rid of them milk solids and the water out of it. And we're gonna need some of this to make this dish. I happen to have it already in a jar, so I'm going to use that instead of making it myself, but I just told you how. We're also going to make some crispy oven, crispy smashed oven potatoes and some broccoli, steamed broccoli with a bechamel sauce. Fancy stuff, huh? Yum. Maybe some Frenchie's bread on the side or something like that. All right, well, let's go on and commence to proceed with this. I've got some of these little new potatoes, and we're gonna rinse them off really good in some dyed water. And I sure hate to hear about you people in California that running out of water. It falls out the sky over here, South Louisiana, and rises out of the ground. We call it the swamp. So, we're gonna go on and salt this water. With about that much salt. And boil these taters for about, four minutes. About 5-10 minutes, boy, come on. Why don't y'all drill deeper wells? That's what we do, just drill down deep. I think most of our wells are over 3,000 foot deep. Yep, and they flow freely. Put a pump on it, and make some pressure. Pressure. Now, we gotta get some, the catfish don't take long at all. I forgot what I gotta do next. So I got about a tablespoon of butter, salted butter, and we're gonna make a little blonde bechamel sauce for the broccoli. I love broccoli, and it loves me too. Melt the butter, boy. Okay, so we got a tablespoon of butter and a teaspoon of flour. Maybe a teaspoon and a half. That was heaping. Yeah. That was kind of heaping. So we're going to put that in there. And we're not going to make a brown roux. We're just going to make a bechamel, which is blonde. Stir, stir, boy, stir. All right, so into this blonde roux, our flour is cooked. So it's got the raw flour taste out of it. We're gonna put a little bit of nutmeg, just a splash. A little splash of white pepper. You could use black pepper, but it'll make little black specks in there now. And that's all right. We're gonna have a pinch of dry mustard or two. Stir this about. And this is gonna be our sauce for the broccoli. We gotta get some milk in here. And you can put cheese, you can put wine, you can do anything you want. That's what cooking's about. Are you paying attention? Now, potatoes are almost ready. And you want to get them to where they're fork, almost tender. I'll show you what we're gonna do with those. Bechamel sauce, into our bechamel sauce, we're gonna put some whole milk. it's called Ticking Up. You want cheese? Add it. I'll let this thicken up. But I don't want to break it now. You can break it by putting it over too high of a heat. So just do this at a low temperature and try not to spill it on your stove like I just done. So take your taters that are cooked and give them a little smash like that. Okay? We'll do that to all of them. Now take your smashed taters and add some kind of fat to them. Duck fat, chicken fat, bacon fat, and some seasoning. I got some ranch dry dressing mix. And we're gonna put that whole package in there. We also need to put some EVOO in there. And that was probably too much. Be all right. So that's our fat. Now let's just worry this about and distribute everything everywhere. Show you what we're gonna do with them in a minute. Now let's take our happily smashed taters with that ranch garlic seasoning on them, N-E-V-O-O, and go bake these off in the oven. And you can do them flat down on a baking sheet, but then you're gonna have to flip them. So if you put them on a cookie sheet like what I'm doing, a cake cooling rack like what I'm doing, you ain't gotta flip them. Flipper. And they're gonna crisp up big time. All right, so let's make us some seasoned flour for the fish. And we'll get us some flour, just all on purpose flour. Okay? While we're looking for that spoon, it was in a flour bag. Imagine that. Put you some Cajun seasoning in there. And some more salts. And pepper too if you want. Alright, look, watch, we'll do it. Pepper. Some, garlic. Put you some more of that too. Tighten it up, in other words. Get it all tightened up. Yeah, I may have should have put more flour in here than that. Yeah. Let's get us some more on purpose flour. Another scoop. Now there's a whole cup for that stuff. Mix it all up. Use your tools. Okay? And mix all this up together. Now let's get us some of this clarified butter in a pan and coat these catfish down. Watch. So now let's take piece of catfish, drain the water off of it, put it in the seasoned flour, just like that. Okay. We need to add a little bit the Cajun seasoning to it. Come on, boy. Cooperate, hand. A little bit more seasoning. rub that in. Same thing on the other side. And we're gonna set this aside in another pan like that. Get another piece, repeat. All that, drop one of these dogfish pieces into our simmering oil. Cook it about 4 minutes aside. And that is the last one coming out. And we'll sprinkle them all with a little bit of lemon juice. And garnishes. And we got to get them broccolis ready. Broccoli. So I got them broccolis in there. We're going to steam them. And we're going to keep this one warm. A little squeeze of lemon on them. Okay. Now in the bechamel sauce, go ahead and put you some lemon juice and it'll be more better. Stir that all up in there. But don't put it back on the heat because it's going to curdle. Yum. Worry all that in there. There's your cheese sauce, bechamel sauce, or your broccoli. Yum. Okay, so here we got those ranch potatoes. Miss JB is stepping in to help with some fried biscuits with butter. Yum. And frying some oat. Brown butter fried biscuits. Yum. That is very good. There you go. The broccoli steaming broccoli. Come up here, camera boy. The broccoli's steaming and ready. Really, we need to shut that timer off. Oven thingy. Let's just eat. Brown butter fried biscuits. Yum. Brown butter is very good. If you didn't know. And these little taters. The little taters. Look at them. I don't know if you can hear the crunch, but I can. Oh, they're hot. See right there? Oh, yum. Daddy fish is over there. And I want this one over here with the blackened seasoning on it.
Oh. Hands made of leather?
It's kind of hot. Thank you.
They don't all have blackened seasoning, right?
This one don't. That one don't, I don't think.
But they're done, right?
Oh yeah, they're all done. Sprinkle you some lemon on it. And eat the little thing there. This is your taters. Dip them in the cheese, broccoli. bechamel sauce. Well,
did you already put lemon on the fish?
No. The thing I noticed instantly in the Gambinos is that they're using a better quality ingredients. It's real cream cheese and not one that's cut with anything else. That's real cream cheese in there. It's very, very rich. And I think it's really good. Yum.